Good morning. My name is Dr. Alexander Shtilbans, and I'm a movement disorder neurologist. Today, we're going to be talking about updates and treatments of movement disorders. Specifically, we're going to be talking about benign essential tremor, dystonia, and Parkinson's disease.
Okay, now a couple of words before I introduce him. Just want to mention about tremor in general. And as you know, the tremor can have different phases. It could be a tremor at rest when you're sitting doing nothing and your hands start shaking. That's typically seen in Parkinson's disease. You could also have a action or postural tremor, and meaning when you're reaching for something or when you're holding a cup of water. And that could be one of the few things, including benign essential tremor, dystonic tremor, enhanced physiologic tremor, and neuropathic tremor as well. So the treatment for these kind of tremors are different. And there's also combination tremor, which is very rare when one has a stroke in the deep portion, the low portion of the brain brainstem. You could have tremor at all occasions, at rest and with action and so forth. So the tremor is notoriously hard to treat with medications. I'll be honest with you, and you might have experienced it on your own. The medications we have for resting tremor in Parkinson's disease, mainly, we'll talk about that briefly later, but the levodopa, the main medication, can improve the tremor, but might not. The benign essential tremor, so let's talk about that, it's treated traditionally with these medications. Now, these medications, except for the DBS, this is deep brain stimulation surgery. So these four medications have been around for ages, and they're all generic. So primidone, it's anticonvulsant, used initially for seizures, is used for benign essential tremor. Propranolol used as well. Topiramate is a third-line therapy, can be added on. Benzodiazepines could just calm you down if you have enhanced physiologic tremor, so that can improve it. So these are the existing medications. And there's a limit of what you can achieve in terms of the improvement in your tremor with these medications. The ethanol-like medications, there is one in clinical development, it's called Xyrem, and we'll talk about it a little bit later. As far as the clinical development, the new trials aimed to find medication for benign essential tremor. Unfortunately, we're going to be passing that stage pretty fast, in a sense that of the stage of the presentation, there is nothing really going on. This is the only study that I found that was completed. It was phase two trial of the T-type calcium channel blocker. And this is the data showing that in the baseline, that's the spiral analysis, and that's another way. And in 28 days after having taken that experimental medications, you see the spiral analysis improved in both here and here. However, the phase two study did not really reach endpoints. The difference wasn't statistically significant. However, it's phase two, so they are going to do phase three probably, because that's where you really know whether it's efficacious or not. But apparently the efficacy-wise statistical significance was not achieved on the small number of patients they used in this study. So we'll be watching out, because that's yet new development. And the picture of like what essential tremor looks like, you might have seen it, but I'm just going to play it for you. Oops. Here. So that's action tremor, and that's in someone who has a deep brain stimulation surgery. So example of, you see stimulation is on, and the person is able to better pour water from one cup to another, and certainly tremor subsides. And we'll play that video again so you better understand. So this is someone who, we'll have more videos later on, but this is someone who has undergone deep brain stimulation surgery. And let's play it again. So that's off, stimulation is off. And then doctor turns it on, and that tremor improves dramatically. So that's the effect of the deep brain stimulation surgery. I'm sure Dr. Calpert will tell you more about it. And but this is just an introduction to the point that I'd like to make, that if your tremor is severe, it's unlikely that it will be resolved with medications. And deep brain stimulation surgery and some other new techniques, the ultrasound techniques, would be the way to go about that. So on that note,